Pa dobro, u tim trenucima mi smo bili ti koji smo loše reagirali na takve situacije kad je Dalot ulazio unutra i zabio je gol. Nismo ga osjetili, ali prije toga smo loše reagirali kad nismo pokrili igrača koji je primio loptu, mislim da je bio Fernandez, Bruno pa je gurnuo loptu Dalot, tako da je to naš problem koji je bio i nismo uspjeli mi taj problem riješiti s naše strane i mislim da je to bilo osobito prvo problem, puno grešaka naše odbrane. Drugo prvenstvo se mi malo bolje posložili, napravili smo promjene i bilo je kvalitetnije, tako da drugo prvenstvo nije bilo tih opasnosti, ali Portugal je okomita momčad, brza momčad koji ide u prazan prostor i koji je teško zaustaviti.
I think in those moments it was mostly our mistakes, our reactions in the defensive line were not as good as we hoped, even before the law came inside. We didn't cover, I think, Bruno Fernandes as well as we should. So those were our mistakes in the first half that we didn't play that very well. It was much better in the second half. We made some adjustments and played better. But Portugal is a very fast, quick, dangerous team. So it's normal to experience situations like that. Yeah.
Hello, Joana Mendes from Sport TV. Portugal used a line of three at the back many times during the match. Was it something you were expecting or did it surprise you?
Pa mi nemamo velikih nepoznanica i nema iznenađenja između nas i Portugala. Puno smo utakmica odigrali, puno smo tih situacija prošli i nedavno prije par mjeseci, tako da mi znamo da se oni otvaraju sa tri igrača i to je bilo ono što smo očekivali. U tijeku igre su mijenjali taj sistem sa tri stopera, pa je bek ulazio unutra. Nije bilo neko veliko iznenađenje za nas.
I don't think there are many surprises between the two teams. We played a lot of games together, including before 2 months ago. It's usual that they open the play with three players. That's something that we expected, and then they changed the system during the game. It's nothing surprising. That's it. All the
today, and it was one of the best elements of the Croatian team, or at least it seems so. What does he bring to the national team, and in what does he differ from Kramaric that seemed more mobile and seemed to struggle a little bit during the first half?
Pa Matanović je vrlo mlad igrač koji je budućnost hrvatskog nogometa. Ona je baš modren napadač što ga mi tražimo. Agresivan, napada loptu u 16 metara, vrlo pokretljiv, vrlo robustan, čvrst i mislim da će on biti veliki dobitak za nas. Kramarić igrao prvo premijen tog napadača, ali znamo da Kramarić nije klasičan napadač. Njemu više odgovara pozicija iza napadača i to je se drugo premijen pokazalo bolje. Njegov debi i nadam se samo da će još tako nastaviti.
Matanović is a very young player. He's a future of the Croatian team. He's a very modern forward. He's aggressive. He's tough. Moves a lot and brings us something new. He's definitely something extra for us. We know that Kramaric is not a traditional forward. He likes to play behind, and we could have seen that in the second half that it worked better for us.
Hi, Zlatko. Francis Carvalho from 0-0. I would like to ask you about the last game that you had. Your team seemed with the offense more dynamic, I believe. What changed today? The team was didn't seem so dynamic with the ball. Obviously, there are some changes without Brozovic, for example. But what did you feel?
Pa dobro, vi ste u pravu. Nama fali te brzine prema naprijed, više dinamike, više energije, više brzine. Nažalost, mi smo u tome deficitarni i mi nemamo tako široki izbor igrača i roster kao što imaju ove velike reprezentacije. I mi smo velika reprezentacija, ali mi imamo to što imamo i nama to fali. Nama je danas nedostajalo 7 ili 8 igrača koji bi bili ili u prvoj postavi ili bili jako blizu, koji imaju tu nekakvu dinamiku, brzinu, koji su igrali prošlu utakmicu tu protiv Portugala. Hrvatska stvara novu reprezentaciju, Hrvatska ima sad neka pred sobom period stvaranja pripreme za budućnost. I to je sad šansa da neke igrače probamo, ali I da pokušam pravi rezultat u Ligi nacija. Evo, da iskoristim prigodu, nisam čestitao Portugalu na pobjedu na početku, pa evo sad da im čestitam.